Hi, this is Scott Godsey of Daywind Music Group, and we're excited to share some new music from our friends, the Griffith Family, on New Day Records. Their new project is called Relentless, and it's filled with songs of hope and inspiration with fresh melodies and tight harmony. We know that you're going to enjoy our friends, the Griffith Family. Here they are.
That's why he's worthy of praise. See his wondrous works and stand amazed.
Hey, everybody. We're at Daywind Studios here today with our new friends, the Griffith Family, and we are excited about the music that you guys are getting ready to put out. Tell us a little bit about this project and what's going on.
Well, we're pretty pumped up. Our ministry is a marriage based ministry. God restored our marriage about 4 years ago, and we started this ministry, and we've been full time for the last 3 years. And so this record is a reflection of that. There's songs on it that really just speak to what we went through and help us tell our story.
Wow, that's incredible. So 4 years ago, I'm guessing that something pretty miraculous happened in your lives. I mean, you said that this was the time, but what happened?
So really a little over 4 years ago, I wasn't even in church. I wasn't even having anything to do with music. I was a bounty hunter. And so I left that when the Lord restored our relationship. Basically, the way it happened is, long story short, I walked in one day and looked at Julie and told her I wanted a divorce. And I didn't want to be married anymore. Didn't want to be a dad anymore. Didn't want to be anything anymore. I grew up singing music, and I always wanted to do this. I always wanted to travel and always wanted to sing and tell people about Jesus. And from an early age, that's all my family kind of brought us up to do. And when my mom passed in 2006, it just kind of set me in a weird place. And I got out of church and started policing, got away from music and policed for a little while, and then became a bounty hunter. I really liked that. But that the lifestyle, being that I was one of those guys that would go in and try to make sure that I found who I was looking for, I would go deep. I would go so deep that there'd be 2 or 3 days that she didn't even hear from me. And the old saying is, if you hang around a mud hole long enough, you get some on you. And so I was just in a bad place. And I came home that night and told her I wanted a divorce. And Julie asked me for 40 days. And I said, now, Julie, I've seen the movie Fireproof. That's not going to work on me. And she said, if you love the kids at all, you'll give me 40 days. And so I told her, I said, I'll give you the 40 days, but you need to understand that when it's up, I'm gone. I'm completely done. And she starts this prayer regimen over me. And somebody gets her in contact with a book called The Power of a Praying Wife. And she begins to read this book, and then she starts the love dare. And just over time, God began to do things that not even she and I really could see happening in the background. But one day I woke up, and Julie's standing at the edge of the bed, and she's dressed up. She's like the most beautiful woman that I had ever laid eyes on at that point. And I said, where are you going? She said, I'm going to church. And I said, okay, hang on, I think I'll go with you. And she just lit up, because I didn't want anything to do with church.
Sure.
And so that Sunday morning, I'll never forget, we walked in the door, and we were running a little bit behind. And when we walk in, they were singing a song called So Amazing. And there's something about like 200 people singing those couple of words, and the atmosphere in that place just shifted. And Julie went down to the altar that Sunday morning, and I knew it was for me, it wasn't for her. And so the Lord just began to deal with me that Sunday morning. And so a little while later, I followed her down. And when you say miraculous, let me just tell you, this was the craziest thing for me, because I had always wanted to know that God was there and be able to feel God there.
Sure.
And that Sunday morning when I went to the altar, I have a great friend. His name is Justin Truitt. He's one of those guys that when you meet him, he's just gonna run up, he's gonna grab you, he's gonna hug you, and he's gonna just love all over you. He's just that guy. And I just knew that he had come and was praying with me and put his hands on me. And so I just reached up to just tap him on the hand and say, thank you. And I turned around and nobody was there. And at that moment, I realized that God had literally come and wrapped his arms around me and began to love on me. And I gave him everything that day. He restored my marriage. He restored my relationship with him. And I promised him when I stood up that I would never stand on a platform, that I would not tell people what he had done for us. And it's been the most amazing thing. And, you know, here we are, you know, a little over 4 years later, 3 years into a full-time ministry, and we got a record coming out called Relentless, because she was relentless in her prayer for me, God was relentless in his love for me, what else can I say? I mean, this.
And that's special. You know, I think that some of the people watching, you know, today probably have not seen or heard your music or probably didn't know your story. But to know that there's a record that you guys are doing, we call it records. I don't know why we say that anymore. We CDs, but it's like, right. Well, it's streaming. So what is it? It's just music, I guess.
That's
it. But these folks may have not heard this music, but I have. And hearing your story today and knowing what this music is all about and the hope that it brings. And I think that's the beautiful thing about the music that you're putting out as the Griffith Family right now, is how hopeful all of those songs are.
One of my favorite songs off of it is actually my personal testimony, and it's called He Restores. And it just talks about how God just reaches into those dark and broken places that we don't want people to know about. And He comes in and shines His light and just illuminates the dark, I guess you could say, and just shines His love through us, and so He restores us that way.
And the collection of the styles of music that you guys have, it's not just one style of music necessarily. It's a little country, it's a little this, it's a little Southern gospel. I just say, hey, if you like heart music, this is the music for you. And we're excited about y'all being a part of this this New Day Records label that we're doing. So thank you for coming and talking. Now, we've been talking for a little while. I can only imagine the people watching might want to hear and maybe see you guys sing a little bit. You think we should let them get a little preview?
Yeah, absolutely.
All right. Well, here we go. The Griffith Family.
It's not about the name on the church or the letters after yours. It's not about what you know, what you have, or what you can afford. If I had just one thing to say to you, I would say at the end of the day, it's all about Jesus. It's all about real love. It's not about fame or money or power. Those things crumble to dust. His words are like freedom. He says I'm forgiven. It's not a mystery. It's the way it was meant to be. It's all about Jesus. Jesus.